That's plenty.
The jar on the plinth before you seems ancient, but is in surprisingly good condition. It's covered in pictograms that you can't understand, but you're sure you just saw one of them move. The pictograms spin to life, and you're dragged into a dream. You see the lizards of the ancient empire turning their backs on you, casting you out into the wilderness. As you roam, the human apes turn away from you, all but one. One smiles, one opens his arms, one says he'll take you home, Bracchus Rex. He promises power, for a price. He picks off your golden scales, one by one, stripping you down to the bone. He promised you a crown, but all you got were shackles. You try to fight, try to reclaim what's yours, but a woman takes you by the hand and leads you to a tower. He promised he'd take me home, you cry. You are home, she smiles as she seals the door. This is where you belong. Your hand drops away from the soul jar, your skin prickling. In the back of your mind, you hear a small, scared voice whimper before fading to nothing. Something within you strains. You are replete. You cannot absorb more source. The long-dead lizard's visions fade.
I can't help but sympathize with him. He just wanted to go home.
One can't help but have a bit of sympathy. Who wouldn't want to return to their home?
What he did shames his people.
The pictograms on the jar stand fixed and still. You see a shape emerge from the ruins of the broken jar, a lizard in the finest necromancer robes. It grudgingly nods at you as it starts to fade from the mortal realm.
Farewell to flesh. Farewell to bone. Farewell.
The long-dead lizard's visions fade.
I can't help but sympathize.
One can't help but...
You made it all this way.
He trembles and seems to shudder with a quiet sob.
I'm cursed, you know. Bloody Bracchus bound me here to protect his vault. He has my soul in that jar just there. And I can't leave without it. As long as the jar stays unbroken, I can never truly die. I don't rightly know. This was the Source King's way. Befriend you, then destroy you. I was a fool to expect I'd be an exception. His favor was intoxicating. That's no excuse, but it is the reason. Really? You would?
He drops to his knees before you and grabs onto your feet with both hands, head hanging.
Thank you.
place. Look at that wand. It hums with inner source. Lucky find. Lucky find.
Been cursed.
The deity's head and hands are... As you take in its chiseled details, you have a vi-
That shrine seems to have brought me here. What is this place?
The deity's head and hands are missing, severed as if by a sword. You can't tell if this was meant to... The helmeted figure before you slowly turns to face you. He raises his weapon, a great ethereal sword, and rushes forward, ready to strike you. The figure plants a foot before you and swings his sword in one powerful direct strike. You counter the blow and send the figure back a few paces. He springs forward again, faster this time, ready to strike a second blow. The figure charges you head on, ready to plunge the sword into your chest. As he charges, he suddenly evaporates into the ether, passing through your body. Deep, dark cold blooms in every particle of your body. The figure materializes behind you and grabs your head with one hand, pressing his sword to your throat with the other. If you so much as breathe too suddenly, it will slice your jugular with ease.
You are my champion? How I wasted my efforts saving you as the ship went down. Why should I do as you say? You were so easy to best.
He staggers back, holding his nose. The wound on your neck quickly knits together. He smiles.
You may do well after all. Eyes up, child. Look me in the face.
He lifts his visor. Two deep green eyes fix you in their stare. In an instant, you know you are speaking to Ralik, god of all humans.
In a moment of weakness, we were led astray. We have suffered greatly for our mistakes, and our people along with us. But now there may be a way to mend what has been broken.
I see a spark in you. The beginnings of a fire that may blaze our path back to preeminence in Rivalon. This is why I've chosen you. To lead humankind back toward divinity.
This is why you are my selected. My Godwoken. Let me show you.
A great surge of power arrests your heart, your mind. When it passes, you feel ecstatic, replete.
You may have noticed I've tried to help you on your journey. I blessed the water beneath your feet so that it would aid you. Now you have the power for yourself. And this is only the beginning. More and greater powers await you, if only you will seek them. Only one like you can wield them. One marked for greatness. One who can either rise to this great task or let his people fall to ruin. Capability is learned, so too experience. What I need is not the wisdom of experience, but the fire of potential. This I see within you. Above all my many children, I hope I am not wrong. Your purpose will be great, but the first step is simple. Escape the grasp of those who would do you harm. You and you alone must safely leave this place. You and you alone must rise above the reach of minor people.
Ralik visibly bristles at the mention of your companions.
I am not the only of the seven seeking a champion, my child. Your friends may have been similarly summoned by powers that threaten the very existence of our race.
He casts his gaze over the war below, where God fights God in a relentless, bloodless battle.
Times have changed. The gods are at war. The victor will choose the terms of peace. If we fail, if you fail, our race may well be lost. A father knows when he may trust in his children, and when he must intervene. I know that you will succeed, if you choose it. Do not disappoint me.
The ring just got tighter. Something isn't right. The ring's gone, but not its curse. Bloody ring. It's loose. Get off me and stay off.
The ring just got tighter. A lot tighter. Bloody ring. It's loose. Get off me and stay off.
The stone gargoyle trains glistening agate eyes upon you. Its jaws creak open, raining dust as it begins to speak.
You are not Bracchus Rex. Welcome home, Master.
Lock tight. Surely there's another skull around here somewhere.
Stern eyes and a sterner face stare into your very soul. Under the inescapable gaze, you begin to shiver.
Another crawling rat, tracking your stinking paws beneath my nose. Vermin are not tolerated in my house. Begone! Do not doubt my power. I merely...
Careful now. That's a trap.
Careful. I spotted a trap. Careful now. That's a trap. These skulls crumble to dust after one use. Look out. I see a trap nearby. Careful now. That's a trap.
has decreed none of you may approach him!
Glory is mine.
The flames! Douse the flames! It burns! It won't stop!
Is mine.
Meet your maker.
Please, help! The flames will burn me forever! Please, help! The flames will burn!